Upscaling has arrived in Star Citizen, and we've previously had a look at the visual differences between the different upscalers, but in this one I want to compare the performance differences between DLSS, FSR and TSR, and then look at a load of different GPUs and see when is upscaling actually useful and when is it not. Because, spoiler alert, depending on the system you've got, it won't magically fix all Star Citizen performance issues. We're going to try and turn the 3080 into a 4K card, the 6700 XT into a usable 1440p GPU. We're going to see if CIG's own TSR can fix my minimum specs performance. And we're also going to look at performance on my gaming laptop. Can DLSS fix that? A lot of upscaling stuff. And a heads up at this stage, a lot of the upscaling stuff actually has a pretty big knock-on effect on Star Citizen's clouds. For those of you who aren't really sure how upscaling works, all it really does is drops the resolution down a notch and then upscales it back up. So at 4K, you might drop the resolution down to 1440p. You get the performance as if the card was running at 1440p, but then the visuals are upscaled back up to something that looks sort of close to 4K. So it's great technology. It's very impressive. And when we looked at the visuals, we found that DLSS, NVIDIA's option, looks significantly better than FSR and TSR. Now, that only obviously works for NVIDIA cards and newer NVIDIA cards. And so the second best option we found was TSR, CIG's own version, and FSR was third. But how do they perform? On my main system, 7800XUD, 4080, you will see here on this graph at 4K, using the quality settings of each upscaling tech, they're pretty much the same. FSR is slightly behind. I don't think there's much to necessarily read in that. That could just be Star Citizen fluctuating. But all of them provide a pretty decent jump in performance compared to native 4K. It's the same at 1440p. They all perform the same because really all they're doing is dropping the resolution down to 1080p and upscaling back. So you kind of expect them all to be around the same. But again, a decent upgrade from the native 1440p result if you've got a monitor that goes that high in terms of refresh rate. And then at 1080p, well, 1080p native, you're almost CPU bottlenecked. But then with the upscaled results, we're basically CPU bottlenecked on all of them. So again, not much to read into this. The thing we can read into this is that really they all perform basically the same. So that's not a consideration. The real consideration is, again, what we looked at last time, the visual differences between them, and DLSS is miles ahead, really. So let's now look at where these things are useful. And on certain cards, this is great. Certain combinations of CPU, GPU, it works well, and some it doesn't. Again, let's stick with the main system for now. You'll see that going around Lawville, DLSS doesn't really gain you much, maybe a couple of frames. We're pretty close to being CPU bottlenecked anyway, but it's a very fast card and DLSS doesn't really do much here. At 1440p, it's basically the same. We're kind of CPU bottlenecked really in both these cases. It's pretty close between them. But where things get interesting on almost all of the GPUs we're gonna see is the cloud. So you'll see here on this graph, 4K medium clouds is CPU bottlenecked still. But when you put very high clouds on, which as we've seen in the past, looks significantly better, and CIG have made improvements to this, they've made it more performant, but it still takes a pretty big hit at 4K, even on something like a 4080. And then obviously then you've got the top result where you put DLSS quality back on and you're back up to the same performance as you were with medium cloud. So upscaling in this case allows the 4080 to run with very high clouds on basically everywhere. So that in itself is worth doing. And combined with the fact that kind of DLSS kind of looked a little bit better than native in terms of the image quality, really for anybody with a card like this, high-end NVIDIA card, whack it on, put the clouds up as high as you can. We haven't tested that with the reference, the photo mode clouds, because that is very heavy, but very high clouds are basically an option that's available to people with this sort of card. Next up, let's go to the low end. So this is my minimum spec system, the 10400, the 1660, which is my minimum spec GPU, and you'll see here in Quantum Travel, at 1080p, we're seeing decent improvement. Remember, DLSS is only available on 20 series cards onwards, so the 1660 doesn't have it, doesn't have the hardware, because DLSS uses hardware, so we are using CIG's TSR. But this is a good improvement, and in Quantum Travel, again, there's not really much going on, but you are seeing an improvement in performance. However, down in the city, in Lawville, we are CPU bound, and so upscaling isn't gaining us anything here. This unfortunately does nothing. back on the clouds though, and well, there's a little bit of a gain. If you were to put very high clouds on with a 1660, you've dropped under 30 FPS, but pop on TSR and you're back up to basically the same as you were on medium clouds. So even on a slower card like this, it's possibly worth turning on. And the visual quality, we're now upscaling from 720p to 1080p. So look out for kind of smeariness, again, things that we talked about in that video. But from a performance point of view, potentially very high clouds, even upscaled from 720p to 1080p, would look better than the medium clouds. Now onto my lovely gaming laptop. Very loud, this thing, but it actually performs pretty well. In quantum travel, you can see here at 1080p, we've had a decent jump in performance. So that's very nice. I mean, again, it doesn't really do much for you in quantum travel, but it is a bump in performance. In Louisville, however, though, even though this has got a 4050 laptop version, that's actually still quite comfortably outperforming the CPU, the 7640HS. So we are still completely CPU bound in this case. And a lot of people with older hardware, this will be the scenario. You'll just not see any benefit in places like the cities from upscaling. It just won't do anything. And actually, the 4050 is so comparatively powerful compared to the CPU here that whatever you do really on the clouds on this Orizon rooftop, it doesn't do anything. We're still all CPU bound. Now let's look at a few GPUs combined with the 7800X3D. So very high CPU performance with a variety of different GPUs. Let's look at the 6700 XT, which is a great card. I've called it almost the perfect card for 1080p and actually is pretty usable at 1440p. So what we're gonna do is see how much TSR, we're gonna use TSR again here, is gonna help this card to turn from a passable 1440p card to actually really good at 1440p. In quantum travel at 1080p, again, a good bump in performance. When you pop in the 1440p results, you'll see that actually we've taken it from 40 FPS, which is fine and playable, but actually to the same performance as 1080p. So a much better and good result. In Louisville, you'll see even at 1080p, actually, we are seeing a good bump in performance that if you're really hypersensitive to gaming around 60 FPS, you've gone over 60 FPS. With 1440p though, we've taken it from 40 FPS to, again, around the mid 50s. And again, from a playability point of view, depending on how sensitive you are to FPS, that is a much better playable experience. At 1080p in the clouds, we are seeing, again, we're CPU bound here in all of them. It doesn't make any difference at 1080p. But at 1440p, we are seeing a good bump in performance, both for very high and medium clouds. We're going up to around the mid 60 FPS mark. So this is a really good example of when upscaling can really help out a card. When you've got something that kind of can do something like 1440p, this can really help. When you are running a really high-end CPU, like a 7800X3D, but you've got a kind of mid-range GPU, it's really quite impressive what you can get out of upscaling, because yeah, it just bumps you enough, I think, to get something like 6700 XT to the next resolution. A similar situation is the 3080. I've owned my 3080 for a while now, and when I first got it, it was kind of not quite enough for 4K, and we've had to wait really for the 4080 and onwards. Now, with DLSS, quality on, you'll see in quantum travel, we've got everything here, 1080p, 4040p. We can go from 37 FPS in 4K to 65. And again, in my book, that's a win. That's very nice and playable. You can see again, the scaling with the other ones at 4040p, you're still seeing a benefit here, but not really that important in quantum travel. In the city, Louisville, you can see that we go from 40 FPS to above 60 FPS. So a great result again, and it's taking it from kind of passable 4K performance to actually a solid 60 FPS sort of experience. On the Orizon roof, again, you'll see that the clouds really at 4K are quite demanding, and very high clouds is not ideal at 30 FPS there, but whack on DLSS quality and we're up to the 50s. So again, it would be pick your poison really there. Would you want the medium clouds at 82 FPS versus the very high clouds at 54 FPS? I would say that the very high clouds probably look visually good enough that I'd probably go with that rather than the extra frames. Next up, let's look at the 2060, which is it's kind of the slowest DLSS card that's out there, maybe on desktop, maybe the 3050 is a bit slower, but it's a 1080p card. So can we squeeze more performance out at 1080p? You can see, again, as we've seen basically consistently all the way through this, when you've got enough CPU headroom, you can get a good boost in quantum travel. And at Lowville, this is a good use case. I don't know how many people are going to have a really high-end CPU like a 7800X3 and pair it with a pretty low-end 2060. But if you do, or if you're waiting to get a new GPU, you're going to see a decent amount of performance here. We've basically gone from being GPU-bound at 51fps to CPU-bound there with DLSS on. And again, with the clouds, very high clouds are very usable here with DLSS quality on. So again, choose which one you prefer, the medium clouds with slightly higher FPS or the very high clouds with slightly lower but better visual quality. What are the takeaways from all of this? Well, as we saw at the start, they all effectively perform the same. So use the one that your GPU will support that looks the best. So for NVIDIA users on newer NVIDIA cards, use DLSS. It looks by far the best and potentially better than native. But for NVIDIA cards that don't support it, AMD users, Intel users, well, from what we found, TSR is the next best option. The next big thing to look at from a visual side of things would be the cloud quality. Apart from the laptop, I think all of the combinations saw an improvement in performance when using upscaling with the clouds. You could generally go from medium to very high clouds and you'd see a visual improvement from the game as well as a performance improvement. So that's a big thing to look at, and I'd recommend everybody basically takes a look at that, the different combinations of very high with the different upscaling options. From a performance side of things, in theory, VRAM usage will actually be lower if you're using upscaling because you're dropping the resolution down from, say, 1080p to 720p, you're using less VRAM. And so if you've got a card that is really struggling, maybe it's a 4GB, potentially even 6 or 8GB card, dropping down your render resolution with upscaling could actually really help your card. On the flip side of that, the VRAM scenario, you might have a card that's actually quite slow, but it's got plenty of VRAM. And so something like the 1080 Ti isn't slow, it's very quick at 1080p still, but at 1440p, you can almost prolong the lifespan of a card like that because it's got plenty of VRAM, it will last for a long time, but you could now boost its performance by using upscaling. Similar story with the 3060 that's got 12GB. It's loads of VRAM, will be fine for a while. It's not a very quick card though, but using upscaling, you can boost its performance and again, extend its lifespan. But the big thing to talk about, as it always is with Star Citizen, is the CPU performance. If you've got an older or slower CPU, that will likely be the bottleneck for your system, especially in the cities. On the minimum spec system and on the laptop, we saw that you can do as much upscaling as you like, and it doesn't really give you any performance in those parts of the game. If you've turned on upscaling over the last few weeks and thought, why is there no performance? Why is it not doing anything? It's probably the CPU and combination with the RAM as well, maybe. But if you want to talk through upscaling or any other Star Citizen PC performance stuff, come and join the Discord. There are loads of people on there who are amazing and very, very helpful and will be able to help you with upgrades, troubleshooting, all sorts of stuff. So lots of people on there who are much more knowledgeable than me.